Once again, I welcome you to the platform of online learning. So today I would like to have a class on the demand analysis. So let us understand what is demand. So in layman definition, demand should be backed up by capability to buy, willing to buy, and desire to pay. If these three concepts are gathered, it is referred as demand. So demand is the quantity of a good that consumers are willing and able to purchase at various prices during a period of time. So the law of demand states that higher the price leads to lower the quantity of demand, and lower the price leads to higher the quantity of demand. So demand curves and demand schedules are tools that are used to summarize the relationship between quantity of demand and prices. So what a buyer pays for a unit of the specific product or service is called as price. The total number of units purchased at that price is called as quantity of demand. An increase in the price of good or service almost always decreases the quantity of demand of that good or service. So conversely, a decrease in the price will increase the quantity of demand. So for example, when the price of X commodity goes up, people look for always to reduce their consumption of X commodity, and they try to get another commodity which price is low. To this situation, economists call as inverse relationship between price and quantity of demand. This is also referred as the law of demand. So here in the analysis of law of demand, we can find out that two important variables, they're called as demand and price. So here demand is the dependent variable, price is the independent variable. So always price influencing on the demand. So therefore the demand is a function of the price, that is expressed in the formal way D equal to F of P. I mean, the demand is the function of price, where D means demand, P means price, F means functional relationship. So let us understand what are the determinants of law of demand, or what are the factors affecting on the law of demand. While we defining the concept of law of demand, we say that when the price increases, demand decreases. When price decreases, demand increases. But other things remain constant. So what are the other things should be remained in the constant? Income, taste and preference, price of related goods, climate, future expectation. These things should be constant in the law of demand. If for example, these things are not constant, what happens? If income increases of a consumer, if consumer's income increases, his demand for the product also increases. If the income of the consumer decreases, his demand also decreases. The taste and preference should be constant. If the taste and preference of the consumer are being fluctuated, the demand does not operate. Price of the related goods also. Related goods might be referred as substitute goods or the complementary goods, and climate also. Then future expectation is also referred as the speculation. Let us understand the demand schedule. So demand schedule refers a tabular representation of relationship between price and the demand. It demonstrates the quantity of product demanded by an individual or a group of individuals at a specified price at a time. So demand schedules are divided into individual demand schedules and market demand schedules. So let us understand the demand schedule in the individual way. So here table shows a particular commodity. You may assume that the name of the commodity A, So, when the price of a commodity is 10 rupees per kilo, the person buys around 15 quantity of a price. When the price of a commodity increases from 10 to 15, the same person willing to buy only 10 quantity of demand. Because the price increases, here quantity of demand decreases. Again, when the price of a particular product, maybe A, rises from 15 to 20, then again the same consumer will buy the A product 8 quantity of demand. Again, the two quantities are decreased by a particular consumer because of price increases and the demand decreases. Likewise, when the price of a commodity per kilo increases from 20 to 25, the quantity of demand will be only 4. Again, when it increases to 30, the quantity of demand is only 2. This schedule shows that the price of a particular commodity and quantity of a particular commodity has the inverse relationship. I mean, when price increases, demand decreases. Let us understand the demand curve. So the same data is represented on this curve, this diagram here. The vertical axis shows that the price of the commodity, and this horizontal axis shows that the quantity of the commodity. When a commodity price is 10 rupees, a person will buy 16 quantity. When the price of a commodity rises from 10 to 15, this quantity of demand decreases for 10. When again the price rises from 15 to 20, again the quantity of demand decreases for 6. When again it rises for 25, the quantity of demand decreases for 4. When it increases for 30, the quantity of demand decreases for only 2 quantity of demand. Now you understood the demand schedule and the demand curve in the individual market. So let us understand what are the critics for law of demand. So the demand analysis are being criticized by various economists. In fact, these criticisms are referred as exceptions for the law of demand. Let us understand one by one. So we have peculiar term. It is called as Veblen effect. The term is named after the American economist Thurston Veblen, who is the best known for introducing the term of conspicuous consumption. So what is the Veblen effect? Here, the Thurston Veblen made a research and he found out that luxurious items which do not operate in the law of demand. I mean, there are some prestigious item which do not belong to the operation of law of demand. So a Veblen good is a type of luxury good for which demand increases as the price increases in apparent contradiction of law of demand, resulting in upward sloping demand curve. Here what we say, when price increases, demand decreases. But in the Veblen effect, when price increases, demand also increases, because here people want to show their prestige, and here they don't consider the price of the commodity because they want to show the prestige. So this situation is referred as conspicuous consumption. It is also called as the prestigious consumption. So, a higher price may make a product desirable as a status of symbol in the practice of conspicuous consumption, and a product may be Veblen good because it's a positional good, something few others can own it. So, Veblen goods include expensive Swiss watches, designers, handbags, certain wines, jewelries, and luxurious cars, they are in the demand because they are expensive. I mean, in a layman definition, the Veblen effect means the people will buy some of the luxurious items irrespective of their prices because they want to show their prestige. Then let us understand Giffen goods. In fact, Giffen goods, the term Giffen goods was coined in the late, named after a noted Scottish economist and statistician and journalist, Sir Robert Giffen. The concept of Giffen goods focuses on low income, non-luxury products that have very few close substitute. A Giffen good is a low income, a non-luxury product that defies standard economic and consumer demand theory. Demand for Giffen goods rises when the price rises and falls when the price falls. So, in econometrics terminology, this result in upward sloping demand curve, contrary to the fundamentals law of demand, which creates the downward sloping demand curve. So, the next criticism for the law of demand is called as bandwagon effect. The bandwagon effect is a psychological phenomenon in which people do something primarily because other people are doing it, regardless their own beliefs, which they may ignore or override. So this tendency of people to align their beliefs and behaviors with those of a group is called a herd mentality. The term bandwagon effect originates from politics but has wide implications, commonly seen in the consumer behavior and investment activities. So here, bandwagon effect refers the desire or demand for a good of a person who wants to buy in style because the possession of a good is a fashion and therefore many others have it. It may be noted that this bandwagon effect is the important objective of marketing and advertising strategy of several manufacturing companies who appeal to go in for good as people of style are buying. So bandwagon effect means people will buy some of the commodities because the commodities are different from the normal commodities. That is called as bandwagon effect. The next criticism for the law of demand is snob effect. The snob effect is a phenomenon described as a situation where the demand for a certain good by individuals of higher income level is inversely related to its demand by those of the lower income level. So the snob effect is a situation is derived by desire to own unusual, expensive or unique goods for consumers who want to use exclusively products. Price is quality. These goods usually have a higher economic value but low practical value. The less of an item available, the higher its snob value. Examples of such items with a general snob value are rare works of art, designer clothing, and sports cars. So, thank you so much for watching this video.